Bhagavate Sri Ramanaya.
I am going to share with you one of the great Mahatmas. I have had the good opportunity to move with very closely. Ours is Rishi Marga. From Rishi is our source. Our sustenance is by the grace of the Rishis, and we will all be absorbed into the Rishis. This is the Rishi Marga.
This was Viswanatha Swami who told me, this is the Rishi Marga. It begins with you, matures in you, develops in you, and ends with you. Yet, we should not forget our origin. I belong to Parasara Gotra, Vashishta Gotra, Viswamitra Gotra. Our lineage begins with Mahatmas, not with kings, your own grandparents. So, kindly, humbly listen. We are going to share with one of the greatest Mahatmas who lived in our midst. It looks like now a dream. The only qualification that you need, if at all qualifications are needed, have an intense desire to know what is the truth. What is this morning? What is this evening? What are it that you are eating, sleeping, and doing so many other works? What is all this? What is the meaning? There is a higher purpose. As Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi said, the only purpose of life is to realize the truth, the self. He did not stop there. The next sentence is guidance for us. All other activities are waste of time. Bhagavan is not condemning anything, but is trying to making an effort to wake us up. Wake us up to what? The only purpose of life is to realize the self. It was my good fortune I could move with more than 100 old devotees of Bhagavan. When they heard about Bhagavan, they gave up everything and came to Bhagavan. Their youth. They sacrificed their youth, their comforts, their name, fame, everything. The same Viswanatha Swami, whom I am going to share with you, told me, see, I was so young and immature. Ungalapati solunga Swami, Ungalapati, I will be scratching them. Tell me something about yourself. Tell me something about yourself. I wanted to know what exactly was your relationship with Bhagavan. What bound you to him? Because I was young, I was only 20, 23 years old. And all of us have undergone that age. How bubbling with activity and distractions we have lived. I asked him, tell me something. He said, in those days, the 19s, if one has 30 rupees, if he earns, this was Viswanatha Swami's description, if one earns 30 rupees, a middle class family of husband, wife, two children can happily live 1 month. At that time, Ganesha, I had the capacity to earn 1,000 rupees per day. I came to Bhagavan just to saw him. Finished. I was begging in the streets. Capability is per day. He could earn 1,000 rupees. They were all, the people who came to Bhagavan or come even now coming to spiritual life are not lazy people. Most energetic, most active, most capable. Arthur Osborne was a gold medalist, 10 gold medalists in Oxford. When even one gold medal to get obtained in Oxford University is almost impossible. Just as Vishnu Swami said about 1,000 rupees, Osborne said, Ganeshan, I had earned 10 gold medals in Oxford and my teacher had not even completed his school. He was comparing, just as Vishwanatha Swami compared, but Ganesha, I was like a puppy before my teacher. So, have complete reverence for every devotee of Bhagavan who lived with Bhagavan. The greatness about Bhagavan is not that he was great, he said, you are great. When Paul Brunton was enamored, he was alone on the hill by looking at Bhagavan. Later on, I was in correspondence with Paul Brunton. I have never seen him. He wrote, I used to ask him, tell me, write to me something. He said, I know, Ganeshan, I have been totally dedicated to Jesus Christ till I saw Bhagavan. When I saw Bhagavan, my devotion to him was not like he is equal to Jesus Christ. Here is God, the true God. So when Brunton was seated with Bhagavan alone, in great ecstasy, emotional ecstasy, Bhagavan, I know you are God, but he started, that's what he wrote to me after, I wanted to tell him, I am a sinner. So, Bhagavan, you are God, but stop Brunton. If this is Bhagavan, this is also Bhagavan. That's our Bhagavan. Tat Tvam Asi, of the four Mahavakyas, Tat Tvam Asi is the most prevalent in Ramanashram. Because Bhagavan always pointed out, you are the truth, wake up, you have forgotten, wake up. We are going to share about such a giant of a devotee who could earn capacity of 1,000 rupees per day, was begging in the streets. He was not a beggar. As Bhagavan says, Uru Kudai Nidal Kove. They are monarchs. under the umbrella of Bhagavan, under the umbrella of truth. I have written about Viswanatha Swami, Sharada Mar, my mentor. I have greatest respect for her. Even now, she requested me, please, whatever you know more about Viswanatha Swami, write to me an article. Now I am not able to write an article continuously. So I begged of her, if you arrange for a talk, I can share. You record it and then transcribe it, edit it whichever way you want. So it is Bhagavan who commands me to reveal more about Bhagavan. It is not Sharada Ambal who requested me. It is Bhagavan. Kohan used to say, the greatness of Bhagavan is, he is the most grateful guru I have ever heard. Usually gurus demand surrender, slavery from you. Here this is reverse. Bhagavan has blessed every devotee who came to him till he got the emancipation. So here we are going to share with you. There is nobody like that, because to whom else has Bhagavan given this assurance of taking the responsibility of that person's complete spiritual growth? It was only Viswanatha Swami. When Viswanatha Swami's father wanted to take him away, Viswanatha Swami was 23 or 24 years, brilliant. So his father wanted him to become a brilliant lawyer. And Bhagavan protected Viswanatha Swami. Ramaswami, leave Viswanathan here. I will take the entire responsibility of Viswanathan, Viswanathan's spiritual growth. I have described it in the article, that incident. Then what is Viswanathan's role? Young Viswanathan, after hearing this, shedding profuse tears, applied himself from that moment in complete spiritual practices. From 1923 to 1927, he was with Bhagavan. Wherever Bhagavan was going, Bhagavan will say, Viswanatha, wah, come. During his walks, wherever he was going, and explained to Viswanathan every verse devoted to, composed by Bhagavan, on jnana and bhakti. It is not just I will take responsibility of him and ignore him. Complete responsibility. Wherever, when forest walking, he will take Viswanathan. And see, I will share with you what Viswanatha Swami himself said. The relationship, initial relationship with Bhagavan and himself. Viswanatha Swami once told me that being alone with Sri Bhagavan, my Sadguru, was the greatest boon that Bhagavan gave me. For instance, he quoted, one day when Viswanatha Swami was with Bhagavan alone cutting vegetables, Viswanatha, these are Bhagavan's words, Viswanatha, you should be capable of making use of even the dust. You should be capable of making use of even the dust. At the same time, you should be capable of rejecting the entire cosmos as mere dust. I have never heard this anywhere else, from anywhere else, any other teacher. Everything you should make use of, and the entire existence, you should treat them as mere dust. Because Guru bestows the best attention on the disciple. To which disciple? The disciple which applies himself entirely to the Guru. Bhagavan used to say, the effort of the seeker and the grace of the Guru are simultaneous and synonymous. There is no gap. So, Viswanatha Swami was very, very serious in his practices, spiritual practices. Bhagavan had taken him to a small cave. Even now it is there, behind the ashram on the hill slopes. It is so beautiful, you should go and sit. There is only space, only to sit. You cannot even stand up in the cave. From there you can have view of Arunachala, and no one else can see you are there. See the master's attention. Because Bhagavan had advised on his arrival, Viswanatha, don't mingle with people who come here. Most of the time be silent. So to make him help, to help that disciple, Bhagavan had given the order, don't mingle with people, don't talk to anyone, and most of the time be alone and in silence. Bhagavan had to protect also. So he took him to a small cave, sit down here morning and evening, do your practice. Viswanatha Swami said, Bhagavan had approved of his, at that time practice was doing Gayatri Japa. Morning 2 hours, evening 2 hours, sit down in the cave and do it. And look at Guru's grace. Now on the Papa, I will come and see to it that whether you are doing. And look at the disciples' seriousness. After months, Viswanatha Swami went to Bhagavan. Inna Viswanatha, sadhana pannindrikya? Are you doing your sadhana? Yes, Bhagavan. Anna, but, inna Anna? Neenga vandhu paakuren sunnal paakave illiye. You said you will come and see, and you did not come and see. Who said so? I came 3 times, and what should you? Bhagavan coming and standing in front of the cave, Viswanatha Swami did not notice. That is the application you have to do. Guru solpadi nadaka vendum. we complain God or Guru, எனக்கு மாத்திரம் ஒரு ஒரு கிரேஸும் கொடுக்கறது, எல்லாருக்கும் கொடுக்குறார், எனக்கு மாத்திரம் கிடையாது. திஸ் இஸ் அவர் பிரெயின்ஸ் சாபட்டேஜ். குரு டேக்ஸ் மோர் கேர் ஆஃப் யூ தேன் யூ கேன் அட்டெண்ட் ஆன் தி குரு. வென்ஸ் விஸ்வநாத சுவாமி வாஸ் அப்ளைங் ஹிம்செல்ஃப் ஸோ சீரியஸ்லி, he also shared with me. I asked him, did you not have any problem? He said, problems will come up. Yet at a particular stage in his sadhana, young Viswanathan felt the need for further clarifications. We will always have, in the beginning there will be, and you should get it clarified from the master. So he went to Bhagavan. Bhagavan, how can I rise above my present animal instincts? My own efforts have proved futile. I deeply feel that a superior power alone can transform me. So seekers experiencing difficulty is not because of your foolishness or incapacity. That is the process of the, that is the part of the process. If you want to go reach the top, that is your room in the first floor, 40 steps you have to climb up. Only when you reach the 40th step, you can reach the room. After getting up 2 steps, the room has not come. I have not reached the room. This is our, I am not ridiculing. Real sadhaks will feel that. He said, if I climb up the steps, room will, my tom, upstairs room will come. So you will have at every step, because you expect a result. Our whole material life, worldly life, is the barter system. I give you 10 rupees, give me your pencil. This is our life, gives and take. So when you are assured, go by these steps, you will reach the top, your room. Every step we extract, I have not reached the room. So there is, that is foolishness, you should wake up. So he asked Bhagavan, Bhagavan, see the master. Yes, Viswanatha, you are right. This is the beauty about masters. Pada muttale. No snubbing, no discouragement, no comment, reaction of anger or irritation. Going along with you, that is, even Muruganar had told me, the greatest feature of our Guru, Bhagavan, is because everyone starts with ignorance, immaturity, no doubt about it. That's why we go to Guru. And here is the Guru who, Muruganar said, he will come along with your foolishness, like the car going and then suddenly taking a U-turn. He will take along with him, he will come along with you and take the U-turn, find out who complains immediately towards him. Like that, here Viswanatha Swami, when he said, my efforts have not proved successful, I think a higher power, he was meaning only Bhagavan, you have to help me. And Bhagavan knows, yes, Viswanatha, you are right. It is by invoking a higher power, mightier than one's own senses and the mind, that these baser elements can be subdued. Bhagavan agrees with him. I read it again. Yes, Viswanatha, you are right. It is by invoking a higher power, mightier than one's own senses and the mind, that these baser elements can be subdued. If you awaken and nurture the growth of that higher power within you, everything else will unfold from within you. Again, the importance is to you, not to come to me, I will take care. You have to do it. If you invoke and nurture that higher power within you, from within you, the guidance will come. For that to take place, one should sustain the current of meditation uninterruptedly. Meditation, moderation, and how to do meditation, moderation in food and similar restraints taken up studiously and judiciously will be helpful in sustaining the inner peace. All the responsibility, the ball is in your court. We always want the ball to be in his court, and this is a beautiful tennis game. He will always put it on you. When Brandon said, "Bhagavan, you are God," I was about to say, "I am a sinner." Stop, Brandon. If this is Bhagavan, this is also Bhagavan. You cannot escape. Coming to Bhagavan, for all other margas you have escaped. Here in coming to Bhagavan, he will take you to the corner and pin you down. Shiva Swami told me, "Ganesha, Sri Bhagavan's greatest instruction is abide by Guru's words. You too, Ganesha, abide by Sri Bhagavan's sacred words, which are the instruction, his instructions, his teachings. His blessings will pour on you." Such blessings from all devotees is what you see here. Then Viswanatha Swami quoted a verse of Sri Muruganar from Guruvachaka Kovai. The meaning of that verse is, quote, "When even in the worldly affairs success is impossible, without proper zeal in one's endeavor, one should not allow the zeal in doing spiritual sadhana to diminish." Continue to do, Guru Muruganar says, continue to do the sadhana till one becomes one with the limitless Supreme. Viswanatha Swami quoted this. "Ganesha, never look back. Never feel you are insecure, you are immature, you are not capable of doing. These are all from your brain. Brain is filled with thoughts." Bhagavan, one place in talk, says, "Thoughts are your only enemies. We do not have Bhuta, Pishashi, nothing to disturb you." One's own thoughts are, Bhagavan says, Bhagavan never uses harsh words. Here, he specifically uses, "Thoughts are your only enemies." God's operation through human beings, this is generally I'm sharing, through avarana and vikshepa. This is a practical, this is not a theory. This is not Advaita. This is not somebody's theory. It's a practical thing. Avarana and Vikshepa. Avarana is veiling, hiding. Vikshepa is projecting. The truth that is within you, confirmed and repeatedly emphasized by Mahatmas, we do not know. The Self, the Truth, the God, that is the veiling, avarana. Vikshepa is projecting this world, anything that is seen by you to be the truth. Because that is the untruth. The truth that is within you is hidden, and the untruth that is around you, which is made to be true. How can I deny this? So many people in the presence of Bhagavan, when he was saying this, they banged on the floor. Bhagavan, how can we say this is untrue? You have to experience. Bhagavan very compassionately says to that man who banged, find out this very same place. If you sleep here, when you are asleep, whether this hard ground is there, do it. Immediately put it into practice. You take it to the brain to argue. No, no, Bhagavan, Bhagavad Gita says something like that. We argue. Do it. But the whole teaching, the practical aspect of the teaching is awake to the truth and reject the untruth. How to do it? As Viswanatha Swami said, it is not possible for me. I need the help of a higher power. That higher power is saying here, the presence of the Guru enables you to give up the untruth and plunge within and be the truth. That right about on U-turn takes place in the presence of a true Sadguru. This is what happened to Viswanatha Swami, like all other devotees of Bhagavan. This turning about, going back, diving back into the heart, traditionally it is called, our Nochur Ramana has written about it. He calls it Tirtha Kshetra. When a river flowing, when suddenly it takes a U-turn towards his source, that place is very holy. In Varanasi, Mother Ganges takes a complete U-turn. And that's why Kashi is absolutely sacred. Even people like Guru Nanak, Ramanuja, Madhva, all the teachers holding to different schools of thought, without fail they went to Kashi to be in that Tirtha Kshetra. The point where the flow gets arrested and then taking a U-turn, our whole attention, senses and mind is outturned. That's how God has created. That's why we are not able to. If I say close your eyes and meditate, you say, I am not able to. You are not bluffing. You will not be. Unless you go to your Guru. This Tirtha Kshetra has to take place. Even Bhagavan agrees, a higher power is necessary. Exactly this is has happened to all the old devotees of Bhagavan. Even for us, that's why we are here. It is not just a human being, as Bhagavan told Brenton, if that this is God, this is also God. Take a U-turn, to take a U-turn, come to this shrine, sit alone, go to Ramana Ashram, go to Arunachala, go to Tirupati, Meenakshi Temple, any of the samadhis of great masters. There, effortlessly the U-turn will take. When Viswanatha Swami came to Bhagavan, he was so eager. He was a tremendous scholar even then. He was a scholar in three languages, which was very rare in those days. Sanskrit, Tamil, English, and he had already studied all the scriptures. And all that energy of being equipped with such knowledge, it only needed, the whole energy was being wasted by discussions and arguments externally. It needed a right about turn. When he came to Bhagavan, the Tirtha Kshetra took place. This Tirtha Kshetra, though it looks like a complicated word, it is exactly the effect. You get turned. Why do you come here? Why do you go to Ramana Ashram? Why do you go to a temple? Be aware. That is the sacred place. That's why in that U-turn at Kashi, I have spent days and days. That's the place, just for your information I'm giving, how powerful those Tirtha Kshetras are. Though whole Kashi is sacred, but the place where the river takes complete turn, that is where Tulasidas came, sat. That spot is very, very, very beautiful. There is a big opening. You can see the river taking a turn. And he made one Hanuman statue. Even now I can swear that's the most beautiful Hanuman done by Tulasidas. So he will keep that, this side, out of devotion. And for inspiration, when you look, the Ganga Mata could be seen. The whole Tulasi Ramayan came at that Tirtha Kshetra. I have meditated that place. So beautiful. Effortlessly meditation comes. Why should we go to Tirtha Kshetras? Because effortlessly, as Viswanatha Swami asked, I cannot myself make this succeed in my efforts. I feel a higher power is necessary. That higher power you will get in these Tirtha Kshetras. You should meet Mahatmas, be with them, or come to the place like this, or the Samadhis of Mahatmas. You will get that U-turn effortlessly. When Viswanatha Swami, the most sincere aspirant, and the turbulent river like Ganges stood in front of Sri Bhagavan, this Tirtha Kshetra took place. All his natural energies of being equipped with knowledge. He was a scholar of three languages, scholar in Vedas and Upanishads. All that took a U-turn. And he got submerged in the inner silence. Later, Viswanatha Swami himself shared this with me, what exactly happened, what is meant by, in his life, this Tirtha Kshetra taking place. What is that? I am quoting from him. Viswanatha Swami said, "In Sri Bhagavan, I saw something quite arresting, which clearly distinguished him from all others." Which is not a thought, these are all not thought, these are all spurana. Sri Bhagavan seemed to live apart from his physical frame, as though quite detached from it. His look and smile had a remarkable spiritual charm. When he spoke, his words seemed to come out of an abyss. One could see immaculate purity and non-attachment in him and in his movements. I sensed something very refined, lofty, and sacred about him. In his vicinity, the mind's disturbances were overpowered by an austere and potent calmness. In his presence, his unique bliss of peace was directly experienced without the need of the brain or five senses, directly experienced. This I would call Ramana Lahari, the blissful aroma of Ramana. In this ecstasy of grace, I lost the sense of separate individuality, and there remained something grand and great which pervaded all and devoured all. The presence of Sadguru Ramana swallowed up the whole universe in its gracious effulgence. There ruled only the inner peace. Have complete faith in yourself. You have come to Sadguru Ramana. Sadguru Ramana had himself said, the teaching is the teacher. Take up to the teaching. The teacher is always there as the teaching. And Viswanatha Swami lived all his life spending time with Bhagavan, and I am going to share what happened to him after Bhagavan left the body. When Bhagavan's physical presence was absent, almost every devotee left Ramana Ashram. They had not earned any money. Never in their life they did any profession or earned money. Only by begging they were all living. Muruganar, Vishnu Swami, all these. Not just beggars. But when Bhagavan's body dropped, ashram shrank. There was no food in the ashram. So they had to go away. They were all scattered with friends or relatives who could not understand their spiritual worth. And fortunately for me, Mother Krishnabai of Anandashram, when I went to her, she commanded, I asked her, what is my sadhana? Your sadhana is, after Bhagavan left body, the old devotees have gone away and scattered over India. Ganesha, they had left their youth, their pleasures, their hold on the world. So they are scattered. You should go. collect them, bring them back to Ramanashram, attend on them. She actually said, till their end. And fortunately, my dear brothers and sisters, if you listen to a master, a Mahatma, you need not do anything. They will do through you. Through me, 40 to 50 devotees have been brought to the ashram, given comfortable living. When they drop the body, according to their wishes, had buried their body or burnt their body. So in that effort, I was very, very sincere, but it was very difficult to find out where they are. They are so self-denial persons. No one knows. Where is Sridhar? No one knows. So where is Viswanatha Swami? No one could help me. I was in Madras on ashram work. And suddenly a friend, old devotee of Bhagavan, young man, met me at the bus stop. I said, where are you coming from? I'm coming from Viswanatha Swami. I was so thrilled. Where is Viswanatha Swami? She is in the Triplicane High Road. Will you please help me? Yes, I will take you. The bus stop also was in Triplicane, so we walked in. His brother's house he was staying. He was a registrar, Sivaraman. Viswanatha Swami was very fond of that young brother. I don't know whether I can reverse it and say that Viswanatha Swami was very fond of him. So I went to the house. He was reading a newspaper outside. I know him and he knows me. Va Ganesha, va. I have not come to meet somebody. I said, Sir Sivaraman, I am told Viswanatha Swami is here. I'm sorry, I'm not insulting anyone. With great disdainment, Vishunava, Ullar Kampo. So casually, you want to say Vishwanna, his brother, he could see only Vishwanna, brother, Ullar Kampo. When I went, his wife was sick, Sivaraman's wife. She was lying down and two daughters, 18, 19 years old daughters, they were all doing something else. I didn't know where to go. Where is he? This brother of his says, go inside. And lost, after the hall, this one girl, again with the greatest disrespect, ullarkar ponga. I could feel their disapproval of Viswanatha Swami. But when I went there, I sobbed and cried. Viswanatha Swami was seated on the kitchen floor. The kumuti adupu. I don't know how to say that in English. Kari illam potrukum. Phoon udhin rukar. Sardama. I couldn't bear it. I fell at his feet and cried and said, Swami, is this your place? Is not ashram, Bhagavan's abode your place? You see, he wanted to calm me down. Yeah, samaykaren idha solriya, Bhagavanu samachidu. See, this is the greatness of Bhagavan's and Bhagavan's devotees. Why? Why do you say cry and then? Because I am cooking. You know, Bhagavan also cooked. And at that time, I was so young and immature, so I argued back. Bhagavan, yaaroda samayakattliye vandu samayakkalla Bhagavane. Viswanatha Swami, Swami. Bhagavan did not come to somebody else's house and cook in the kitchen. Sari pa enna solre. Please come back to the ashram. Give me a chance to serve you. Abdiya, he was a man of few words. In fact, I gave the title of this sharing. Viswanatha Swami's silence was more eloquent than his speech. Naan pomaten, ungala vuttu pomaten. I will not go away leaving you here. I will come. Then I didn't want to pursue, lest he should deny something. Varamaten appdin solittu arna pandrathu. Ennude ignorance. Sari Swami. The moment I went to the ashram, I wrote a postcard. Swami, you said you will come. Please, I am waiting. Come and give me the blessing, grace of serving you. All his life, of course, after some time, Viswanatha Swami came to the ashram and stayed his last days, gave me that opportunity of serving him. All the time he was holding my card. When the president of this RMCL, my dear Nataraja Mama, A.R. Natarajan, when I first took him to Viswanatha Swami, Natarajan naturally wanted to know, how did you come to Bhagavan Swami? He went inside, took this postcard. This postcard was written by Bhagavan. Bhagavan commanded me to come here. It is Bhagavan who commanded me to come in the ashram. You cannot imagine. Saradamma knows the place where I had put, there was only a bench. No table, no chair, nothing, no other furniture. That bench was everything. When I begged, I'll put a cot, all that. Idu porumpa. And when you move with great old devotees of Bhagavan like Murugana or Osborne or Viswanatha Swami, you cannot use your argument brain. You will be silenced. So I kept quiet, but I insisted on giving him a bathroom. And he protested. They are so simple, so humble. I have to force myself on them. Mudiyadhu Swami, naan pote theerven. And then one of the rooms there converted into bathroom, because my commandment from Mataji is to look after them and give them comfort. I am not as a person, just for name and fame I was doing. Mataji's commandment. He was very kind. When I am doing office work, up to 5 o'clock, I will be very busy. He will come outside, stand. Poru, wah. Enough, come out. Wah, pradarshanam polam, wah. And all this, also he won't say in words. Vare vartha, poru, wah. Then he will start walking. Behind the ashram, he will start walking. And fortunate, I was so fortunate, I could understand it. Edhika navarachanel. Why did you ask me to come out? Should not do. I walked and he took me to the inner pradakshina, which I did not know. I knew only the outer pradakshina. He took me to the inner pradakshina. A You know, when you move with them, you cannot put ordinary questions. Yenga enarishin porel, yenga porel, adalam. Even it won't even come to the mind. That's their power, presence. He himself, out of kindness, said, "Ida ul paade, kaatu paade." Enu Bhagavan sollu. This is the forest root, Bhagavan has said. When I came here, Bhagavan himself took me in this path. Wah, come. And there is a place where the entire hill, Arunachala hill, is hidden by a small hill. Where you have to walk around that small hill also. And at that time, completely the Arunachala is hidden. So he held my hands, Jagradeva. That is, with alertness, follow me. And then at a place he stopped. Now look. Then there are two peaks in Arunachala. Saradambalak teriyum. One peak is Ambal peak, mother peak. All the devotees, that is the Apita Kujambal peak. Then he said, stop and look. Only up that mother peak was seen. Viswanatha Swami said, Idan, Amma Uda Sannidhi. Then he took me a little more, then Arunachala peak. Idida, Appa, father peak. Bhagavan in Arishin Vandade, Bhagavan took me here, he showed me this, Par Viswanatha, Idida, Ambal. Ambal Anagraha Irindata, Appa Vakamipa. Your namaskar manna. One Bhagavan took me there and showed me this is the mother peak. Unless you have mother's grace, the Shakti aspect's grace, she will not show you the father. See, konja nada, var, amma kamikira par, amma. And it's all so real, Sarada Ambal. It was not drama. It was so real. First time when you come and see, it is so thrilling. She said, par, amma kamishita par. Appa ava kamikira par. Par. Namaskaram. See, mother is showing you the father peak. Now prostrate. So every time I go inside in the inner path, I prostrate to the mother peak first and then to the father peak, and to all my close friends also I show that. And then it doesn't stop there. He took me continuously in the inner path. There is after the Adiyannamalai, there is a place where Viswanatha Swami said, now look at Arunachala. The mother peak was becoming prominent, and then the father peak was going inside. At the park, look at that. And we reached in a particular place. From this place onwards, be looking at father and mother. Completely every inch. I was seeing at a particular place, the mother peak completely hides the father peak. Viswanatha Swami shed tears, holding my hand. What is happening? Then he said, Bhagavan took me here, Ganesha. Bhagavan cried. Ambaluda Anugraham. This is the most mystic place in Arunachala. These are the words of Bhagavan. I have spent Saradambal day and night at that place. There is a I don't know what tree, vilva tree or something on the Vathayadipadela. Adilee ukandu paathindu. Pray to Mother Ganesha. Atma jnanam chumma vandradhi, the intellectual, when all the five senses, all the mind, when it got stopped, then self will come out. Alla varadhu. Ambaloda anugraham venum. இங்கே வந்து தியானம் பண்ணு. I am sharing with you these friends not as an information. It's not an interesting information. These are all life transforming truths. When you go there, you should experience this. அப்புறம் ஒரு நாள் அங்கே அதே இடத்துக்கு அழிச்சுன்னு சேம் ஸ்பாட் திஸ் பூரி சங்கராச்சாரியா ஆஸ்டி பகவானே டவுட் ஹரகௌரி சம்யோகா என்ன என்ன என்னமோ உச்சத்தேன்னு வரும் இது ஒரு யோகா உச்சதே அண்ட் பூரி சங்கராச்சாரியா வென் ஹி வாஸ் இன் துவாரகா பீட்டம் டியூரிங் பகவான்ஸ் லைஃப் டைம் ஹேட் திஸ் டவுட் என்னது சம்யோகம்னு போட்டிருக்கேன் பார்வதியும் பரமேஸ்வரனும் சம்யோகம் பண்ணுற போதுன்னு போட்டுட்டு ஏதோ ஒரு யோகம்னு போட்டிருக்கேன்னு ஹீ ரோட் டு பகவான் ஹீ ஆஸ்ட் ஃபார் அதர்ஸ் தேவர் ஆல் கிவிங் இன்டலெக்சுவல் டிஸ்க் எக்ஸ்பிளனேஷன்ஸ் பூரி சங்கராச்சாரிய கிரேட்டஸ்ட் மேத்தமேட்டிஷியன் ஸ்காலர் ஹீ வாஸ் நாட் சாட்டிஸ்ஃபைட் அண்ட் தென் ஹீ ரோட் டு பகவான் சுவாதியார் சுந்தரேசியர் சொன்னது இது He used to take letters to Bhagavan. Bhagavan used to dictate to Vadyar Sundaresiyar, teacher, Pandit Sundaresiyar. So Bhagavan told him after reading this letter, Avare inga varachollu puriyum. Ask Sangracharya to come, then he will have clarity. He did not say puriyum because Bhagavan's teaching is ariyardum puriyardum பிரயோஜனம் இல்லை கிளாரிட்டி வேணும் யுவர் நோயிங் பகவத்கீதா ஆர் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங் பகவத்கீதா இஸ் நாட் இனஃப் யூ ஹாவ் டு ப்ராக்டிஸ் அண்ட் மேக் இட் யுவர் ஓன் ஆஸ் அன் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் அதுதான் பகவான் தெளிவுங்கிறார் தெளிவு வேணும் அதை தான் மீன் பண்ணி சந்தேகத்தை கேட்டுட்டார் லெட் ஹிம் கம் ஹியர் Puri Sankaracharya comes, it's all in letters from Ramana Ashtottaram. Bhagavan then tells him, enna irukku, idhila enna sandeham? Manasu aatmala udungiradha hara gauri samyogam. Nammude mind getting dissolved in the self is hara adha andha yogam. அப்படின்னு சொல்லியிருக்கார் பகவான் இங்கே அவரை விஸ்வநாத சுவாமி வென் ஐம் சாரி ஐம் மிக்சிங் அப் தமிழ் அண்ட் இங்கிலீஷ் வென் விஸ்வநாத சுவாமி வாஸ் ப்ராட் டு தட் ஸ்பாட் பகவான் டேர்ன் டு ஹியூம் அண்ட் செட் இதுதான் நான் பூரி சுவாமிகளுக்கு சொன்னது ஸோ விஸ்வநாத சுவாமி செட் தட் இஸ் த மோஸ்ட் சீக்ரெட் பிளேஸ் And then in those days, I was so enthusiastic, people coming, I will take them round the ashram, round the hill, and very rarely up the hill also, if they are very, very sincere seekers. Many times I have taken many people. One day Viswanatha Swami, enga poyittu vara, where did you go? I said, very proudly, I took all these people. To the top of the hill. Oh. அங்க அருணாச்சலேஸ்வரர் பாதம் இருக்கு பாத்தியோ. I proudly said, I have taken all these friends to the top of the hill and brought them back. You see, the unconscious ego is always there. I always separate between good ego and bad ego. This is good ego, it's not bad ego. Bad ego is to hurt others. To own something and be happy, that's the good ego. So, With that good ego, I said, Vadalna Aishinu, Uchimalaga Aishinu Baitavaran Swami. Did you see the holy feet of Arunachala? I have never seen. Because the highest rock there, on which they will put a cauldron and then light it on Deepam day, that is what lit. And I thought, people, all the other old devotees said, that rock, huge rock, completely covered with the old oil patterns. Adhikadha namaskar mintu urvan. We used to do namaskar and chant Aksharmana Malai, offer some prasad there and come. Yeah. And the padam, adhik pakkathiliye ur paare irukku. Next to it, a little lower, there is a rock, in which huge size Arunachala's sacred feet are engraved. Ganesha, one madriyeda nana, chinna vesla bhagavanta vandabodhu, seekers all arshin, uchimalaka arshin, boitu varume. I'm sorry. And like you only, when I was here very young, I used to take enthusiastic new aspirants to the top of the hill. And one day, just as I asked you, Bhagavan asked me, Viswanatha, yenga poyittu vare? Where did you go? And the same way I said, ivalella uchi malai kaashin poyittu vare. I have taken all these people to top. Ama Viswanatha, anga appavoda paadam irukku paathiyo? Did you see father's footprints there? He said, I know. Poi par. Immediately, that was even night, or almost night was setting in. I went all alone and rolled on that feet, because my Guru Bhagavan has said, Appa avada padam. Padatta, Guru padatta pidikanam. You will get emancipation only by holding on to Guru's feet, holy feet. Then Viswanatha Swami said, there are two sonic spring, but inside the caves. In Tamil, they call it sonai. When the spring, natural spring is inside a cave, they name it Sunai. So Bhagavan had told us there are two springs like that inside the cave. One is called Lily Pond, Alli Junai. Another is called Kuninji Kudichan Junai. Lily Pond. Another one is scrawling and drinking the water cave. Kuninji Kudichan. You have to, like a lizard, you cannot sit and go. You have to crawl and then go inside. There will be big opening, and never these two will become dry. And of course, Bhagavan did not say that, but Viswanatha Swami told me, Adi Amrutam pa, Adi Vattave Vattadu. It is Ambrosia, Arunachala's blessing. So, during Bhagavan's lifetime itself, Viswanatha Swami and Kunji Swami searched for these two caves, spring caves, and they easily found out Anli Jone. Any of Kunji Swami Aishinbhai Kamchirkar. They searched every inch of Arunachala. They could not find out that Kuninji Kudichan Jone. So with disappointment, they came and told, Viswanatha Swami came and told Bhagavan, Bhagavan, and the Kuninji Kudichan Jone, எங்களால் கண்டுபிடிக்கவே முடியல. ஓஹோ, அப்படியா? ஒருவேளை அது சித்தாளுக்கு மாத்திரம்தான் உபயோகப்படுத்தலாம் போல இருக்கு. ஓஹோ, இஸ் இட் ஸோ? ஸோ பெர்ஹாப்ஸ் ஒன்லி சித்த புருஷாஸ் ஹூ ஆர் இன்விசிபிள், தே அலோன் கேன் மேக் யூஸ் ஆஃப் இட். why Viswanatha Swami told me was, Kunju Swami was narrating to me about Kurinju Kudichan Jone. After that, next day or next day, Viswanatha Swami called, hey, the Kurinju Kudichan Jone, Pakunan Pakade. Don't go in such a way. It's a waste of thing. It's all wonderful to live with old devotees, my dear mother. It's wonderful. And then Bhagavan, how he guided further after coming to this ashram, Viswanatha, come. Go and do tapas in Pachayaman temple. It is inside the forest, at the foot of the hill, away from Ramana Ashram, where no one can stay because cheetahs and panthers will be visiting. Nobody can go there. It is intense, thick forest. But Bhagavan told Vishwanathan, go and stay. Naturally, like our immediate reaction, ange eppadi saapradhu? He got that thought. Town is very far and it is very difficult to come. It is risky also. The danger is always there. Adhe porabodhu konja aval eduthunu po. Avalum vellamu eduthunu po. When you go, because Vishwanathan had this thought, what about my food? Because he cannot come to beg in the town. Take some beaten rice and jaggery. Vishwanatha Swami told me this. And ennoda brahmana moola aval mathra saapta eppadi saapradhu, you know, it is hard. Immediately Bhagavan understood it. He said, ratri oru tuniyila avala katti andha kenathila potudu, andha kolathila potudu, adu nanna oori irukum, samacha mari nanna irukum. Kartala, adu vellathode eduthu saapidu. This is for the physical care. Then, how to, that beaten rice, he advised, because Viswanatha Swami felt, how can I eat raw beaten rice? Bhagavan told him, tie it in a cloth and put it in the water spring there. Early morning, it will be cooked and add with jaggery. Even these minute details I am sharing, my dear friends, you should know the depth of care the Guru takes on us. Our doing just a puja and doing some prostrations, we think we are very devoted. And then he told him, this is for the body. Then for the mind, Bhagavan says, kalam desam vartamanam moonriyam marandiru. Time, space and causation. Causation is our relationship with our own family and with others, with the world. Forget completely time, space, where you are, and all your relationships. Mind will be roaming about kalam, desam, vartamanam, moonriyam marandiru. For next form, word, maunamayiru. Because the mind will say, how can I remain forgetting all these? How can you forget time, sir? Or space, Bangalore, Trivannamalai, or your family, Vartamanam. When you are in silence, Bhagavan's guidance. Kalam desam Vartamanam moonriyam marandiru. Maunamayiru. And that is not the end of the sentence. Yangata vandu sollu. And come and report to me what was your experiences. I'm always, when I think of that, I inwardly cry. How kind. We simply say Guru's grace is compassionate. Just words. We use dry words. You should experience it, how they take care. And he told him, do intense tapas. Bhagavan used the word, intense tapas padano. Intermittent tapas illa. Intense tapas. Namma sastramo mahatmakal solradadda. Bhagavan uses all this, I mean not in English. Uninterruptedly, Bhagavan will add that. You have to do meditation uninterruptedly. Because the Vartamanam will come. இங்கே குழந்தை கூப்பிடுறான், இன்னைக்கு ஸ்கூல்லேருந்து வருவான், நான் போய் அழைச்சின்னு வரணும். சம் ரிலேஷன்ஷிப் வில் டிஸ்டர்ப் யூ. அண்ட் மோஸ்ட் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் வெரி பியூட்டிஃபுல் திங், வென் ஐ வாஸ் இன் தி ஆஃபீஸ் அண்ட் சடன்லி அட் 2:00 விஸ்வநாத சுவாமி கேம் அண்ட் ஸ்டூட் அவுட்சைட் and I am facing this side, Viswanatha Swami is behind. That's the grace. Suddenly, for no reason, looked and he was standing there. Odipe namaskaram panna. I went and prostrated to him. Bah, I didn't want to disturb you, but I could not but come to you, Ganeshan. Solunga Swami, please tell me. To see you, I came from my room. And there is Palitirtham in ashram. For no reason, I was drawn to the steps leading to the tank. And something made me sit on top of the steps and look at that water. Bhagavan was swimming there, Ganesha. I saw physically. Bhagavan is a great swimmer. Vishwanatha Swami is related to Bhagavan. They all know in Madurai, Bhagavan was the best swimmer. He will challenge other students. And Madurai Peppakalam, inge irundha anga na poittu odane inge thirumbu, impossible. Moochu vaangam panna mudiyadhu. So Vishwanatha Swami had great admiration for Bhagavan swimming. And Bhagavan drew him to that place that day and gave him darshan. When I say Bhagavan, all this Vishnu Swami said, I am not adding any word. Bhagavan was floating because I had never seen Bhagavan swim. Bhagavan's speciality is he will lay both hands and legs, just the body will be floating. And Bhagavan used to repeatedly share this with others. And people wanted to see, particularly Ganeshan, I wanted to see how could one float for endlessly, for hours you can stay on water meditating. So that day, just now Ganesha, Bhagavan gave me that darshan. I wanted to share with you. See, his seeing Bhagavan swimming is not enough. An ignorant seeker who is struggling on the path has to be encouraged. There was one specific instance. There was a lady in Delhi. The other great things about Vishwanatha Swami taking over mountain path editing, everything I had already written in my article. This I did not include. The whole family, Bhat family, from father they were very devoted. 4 or 5 girls, even from the young age, they were also devoted. His father compelled them to worship Bhagavan's picture. At home, insisted when they were given in marriage, insisted that they should have a picture of Bhagavan with them. So this lady was having a picture and not exhibiting it because her husband was not a devotee. She loved her husband very, very dearly, very, very much. They had a son also. She loved her son also. But her devotion to Bhagavan, she kept the picture in a particular room so that her husband should not see and get disturbed. Unfortunately, one day her husband went into that room. He did not know anything about Bhagavan. He shouted at her, "You are worshipping another man other than me?" He took that picture, took it to the roadside, Kalala Midichi, he put it into the dustbin. She could not bear it. She was affected with a shock, so severe that shock was, like all city ladies, she was always carrying a purse. With that purse, she walked to the airport. There was only one air flight to Chennai at that time. She came in that madness and then took a taxi and came to the ashram. Completely shattered. Beautiful lady, house lady, completely uncupped hand. And then the salwar kameez, everything was so dirty, and she came crying, continuous crying. I didn't know how to handle her. Though I arranged for a room, my only escape is always Bhagavan shrine. Vang, vang, Bhagavan shrine pola vang. I took her to the Bhagavan shrine, and I didn't know. She is not answering or talking anything. And it was almost night. How to handle her, how to deal with her? Viswanatha Swami walked in. I didn't know her condition at that time. Viswanatha Swami, he immediately understood. Ganesha, avala engatta uttru naan paathukuren. Don't worry about her. I will take over. And for 3 days, Viswanatha Swami spent time with her, took her to the Arunachala temple, and she was all the time crying. I don't know what all he did. She became all right, calm. Then Viswanatha Swami said, she is terribly afraid of her husband, and we will deal with that also. And Swami said, go and pray Bhagavan shrine. I went and prayed that everything should be all right. And Viswanatha Swami had given me a hint. Her husband is a troublesome fellow. And even Bhagavan's picture is another man's picture for him. So I was in the evening, a horse cart came, and a man came. He was demanding, "Yenga," her name I don't want to say, "Yenga, where is she?" I got so frightened. I don't know what he will do, because Viswanatha Swami has taken his wife around the hill. I know that if she comes along with Viswanatha Swami, walked in, I didn't know. I mean, these are all my ignorance, my shortcoming. I was really terrified. I was keeping him at the Ilupa Marath Kadila in the Pakam, receive Pundi. I have been receiving him. Suddenly, Viswanatha Swami and that lady came, entered into the ashram. I'm very honest, I was really terrified. But that is the beauty. The miracle happened. He could naturally see his wife. He went and fell at Viswanatha Swami's feet. Anticlimax. She had returned to him. For me, it is an anticlimax. But she had written to him how noble this Viswanatha Swami is, that you should. He had come because her son is crying all the time at Delhi. So he had come to take her home. Afterwards, Viswanatha Swami is going to tell me what all happened, what is this picture being thrown away. That is one of the greatest moments in my life. We can talk philosophy. We can give a lot of advices. But to take the problem on oneself and dissolve it amicably to the satisfaction of everyone. I was able to take, very sincerely I took care of Viswanatha Swami. I'm not talking about myself, how precious they are. When you meet a Mahatma, you have to give everything to them. It's truth, they are the truth, embodiment of truth. That's why I'm saying I took care, not to extol myself. One day he went outside and then came back with heat stroke. He came to the office. Ganesha, udambu seriyilla. Vaa, roomukku vaa. I am not well. Come to the room. I held him because he was tottering. I took him to the room and sat on the bench. And from that moment onwards, he will get up, sit. Continuously. I was shocked to see his pain. Viswanatha Swami, don't look at my body. I'm all right. Don't look at my body. Continuously doing. And I had urgent work in the office, so I had to go. I told one of my friends to look after. Even the whole night, he was standing up and sitting, but talking normally. So the next morning, my friend came and said, "Ennappa apdi uttutiye raatri poora elundirukkarar ukkarar continuously like clock, hands moving about." But ethasapunnona, he says, when I want to help him also, "Leave me alone, I am perfectly all right." He talks very well. So the next day when I went, I started crying. I'm an emotional man, and Sardambal knows. I have no hesitation to cry. Swami said, "Why do you look at my body? All the time doing this. My body is affected. Perhaps my mind also is affected. But the spirit, the heart is unaffected. And the heart is now speaking to you. Every time when I went there, he was saying, don't look at the body. I am one with Bhagavan. I am in peace. Then he said, when he saw me so much worried, Ganesha, உனக்கு நான் தொந்தரவு கொடுக்க மாட்டேன் இன்னும் ரெண்டே நாள் தான். கணேஷா, ஐ ஒன்ட் ட்ரபுள் யூ மோர், ஒன்லி டூ மோர் டேஸ். சம் பர்டிகுலர் டே இஸ் அட் தி டூ டேஸ் ஆஃப்டர்வர்ட்ஸ் ஈவினிங் 5:30. ஆனால் நீ இருக்கணும், யூ ஷுட் பி வித் மீ அட் 4:00 டே ஆஃப்டர் டுமாரோ. அண்ட் பகவான் ஹேஸ் கால்ட் மீ day after tomorrow evening 5:00, I will follow Bhagavan. Come at 4:00. Then on that day, see how ignorant we are all, Saradambar. I was so busy, he sent me a person. Viswanatha Swami in that condition, he sent my friend who was put as attendant. Poi Ganesh marandra poram 4 mani nu solittu va. Go and tell Ganeshan he might forget at 1:00. 4:00 he had to come here. I went at 4 o'clock. Again he said, this body is affected, perhaps the mind also, but the spirit, the heart, is unaffected, and the heart is now speaking to you. Though there is so much of confusion, turbulence, and misery in the manifestation, all of that belongs to the realm of the mind only. The ignorant mind split as object and subject. Long talk he spoke to me. All experiences of life are relative, related to the experiencer, the ego, who is nothing but a shadow, having no intrinsic reality of his own. The reality in every person is the ultimate pure existence, which is the spiritual state of I am, that is the awareness absolute, which does not split as object and subject. It is the only thing that matters. If the ego and all its experiences are dismissed as passing shadows, the ever-present ultimate reality alone will be self-evident. Nee paapa appadila sollala, you will see, you will realize, it will self-evident. If one is even intellectually convinced of this truth, one will gain detachment. Jnanam vandrum solla. If one is even intellectually convinced of this truth, one will gain detachment and mental peace. We should now and then stop for a while, stand aloof, and experience this immutable and immaculate awareness absolute, the silent I am, which alone matters, which alone is, despite the manifestation of endless varieties of experiences. The Buddha, Jesus Christ, Adi Shankara, and our beloved Bhagavan are a few standing monuments affirming the reality, which is also one's own being. The very sight of the proximity of these pillars of light reminds one of this reality within oneself, and that brings about spontaneously peace and bliss. Only finite mind, the me, has to be relinquished to merge and dissolve in the ever-present infinite reality of I am. Then he stopped for a few moments, looked at me with the greatest compassion I have ever experienced, touched my head. I bless you, Ganesha. I prostrated before this illustrious devotee who chose to be with Sadguru Ramana and stayed in Arunachala under the spiritual umbrella of Sri Bhagavan, enjoying his protection and guidance. He attained the infinite reality of I am. The greatest lesson Viswanatha Swami imparted to me in his silence, which was more eloquent than his speaking, that it was not enough if one just read some spiritual books and got convinced intellectually, that one should experience the teachings as states of one's own inner peace, quietude, and bliss. And bless me again and again. It was my good fortune that I could be with him. எனக்கு அவர் கொடுத்த பர்சனல் இன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன் விச் எவ்ரி ஒன் ஆஃப் யூ கேன் ஆல்சோ ப்ராக்டிஸ் இன் லைஃப். இங்கே வா, கம் ஹியர். He gave it to me, which will be helpful to anyone, anywhere in the world, which is spiritual yet physical. It is not any theoretical idiosyncrasy. He said, Chinmudra Therima Ganesha. அங்க மாத்ருபூதேஸ்வரர் கோயிலுக்குள்ள அழிச்சுன்னு போய் இன்சைட் தி மாத்ருபூதேஸ்வரர் ஷ்ரைன் ஸ்டாச்சு ஆஃப் தட்சிணாமூர்த்தி இஸ் தேர். பார்த்தியா, சின்முத்ரா, திஸ் இஸ் தி சின்முத்ரா. இட் இஸ் நாட் ஜஸ்ட் ஒன் காட் ஹேவிங் சின்முத்ரா ஆர் சம் கேப்பபிள் பீப்புள் அலோன் கேன் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ். இட் இஸ் வெரி யூஸ்ஃபுல் ஃபார் எவ்ரி ஒன். And then he said, jnana and japa are the same. The state of inner silence, Rama Rama Krishna Krishna Namashivaya Shiva 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 Ramana Ramana Arunachala, they are not different. One should always be chanting a japa, otherwise the mind will go away, wander about, even while you are cooking, while doing office work, whatever serious work that you involve, you must do japa. Naturally the mind will say, protest, as Paul Brunton protested to Bhagavan, Bhagavan, you are in a jungle ashram, I have to go in the heart of New York and London. It's when Bhagavan said, there is no difference between work and wisdom. Viswanatha Swami quoted that and that, said, for youngsters, you will feel it is impossible. How can I do japa while doing work? Then Viswanatha Swami, that is the Chinmudra Rahasya. If you do japa, not necessarily with rosary, it will get dissolved into you. Whatever work that you do, even if you forget japa, these two fingers, it is Ishvara Srishti. The fingers are not yours. Though we say it is my finger, don't touch me. It is not yours, it is Ishvara's. When I am distracted with him, these fingers will join and then the japa will continue. Whatever your disqualifications, whatever your state, I have experienced this in hospital where I was 6 days unconscious. Anuma sonna mani en sonna, the person who, lady nurse who was looking after, I had to be inside ICU, what is it, ICU for 6 days. A lady nurse was attending on her. When I came out and became conscious, she said, adhu enna ipdi kai vechinde irthale. What does it do? Even when you are unconscious, your fingers were joined. So my friends, this is not a cheap technique. This is God's gift. That's what Viswanatha Swami told me. I am doing it. It is very helpful. Whatever your mantra, don't worry. If you do not have a mantra, somebody will come and give you a mantra. Chanting the mantra is almost next to be the self. It will give you contact, touch, like two wires touching. The spiritual thing will come. So always have this Chinmudra. The second thing that he told me was, whether your eyes are open or closed, sleeping, the eyeballs, when they go up, then only you are able to think, thoughts come. Eyeballs will go up. These are all Viswanatha Swami's words. And involuntary also, all the time the eyeballs will be going up, you are not aware. You will be looking at me, but while talking, it has that movement towards that. And when it looks down, then peace, silence comes. And he told me, if you see the pictures of Swami Vivekananda meditating, you can see the eyes, the bottom of the eyes you can see. Because that's why Bhagavan said, focus your attention inward, looking at the right side heart. Because we cannot force our eyes to look down, because it will become mental. I must look down. But first time make an effort to look down towards that heart. Then automatically all thoughts will stop. That's why Bhagavan says, do meditation uninterruptedly. That day Viswanatha Swami disclosed this secret. When you meditate, many of us, our experience is, I am disturbed, I am not able to continue for more than a few seconds or a few minutes, because thoughts rush in. This if you do, that's why Bhagavan specifically said, close your eyes to Kohan. And in another place he says, focus your attention on the right side of the chest, in the heart. It is not that you have to go in search of a heart so that the eyeballs will look down without your effort, without your consciousness. Please, my dear friends, do your meditation. 100% success. Just by closing our eyes, thoughts will rush in. As Viswanatha Swami told Bhagavan in the beginning itself, I am not able to control my basic instincts. This is everyone's trouble. You want to meditate, but when you close your eyes, distractions. When you focus, please focus your attention. Whenever you sit for meditation, whether it is for a minute or hours, in the beginning, you have to make an effort to look down. When you look down, it will escape. That's why Bhagavan says, focus on the right side of the chest. Your meditation will be blessed by Bhagavan. Please, this is your life. This is not an Advaita or some teacher, Ramana Maharshi is teaching. This is your life. That's why Bhagavan, all devotees of Bhagavan, Muruganar, Kavikanta, all of them will quote, Tatu Tvamasi, you are that. That is very important. It is not a propagate Maharshi's teaching. It is to awaken the listener. When you listen, the awakening takes place automatically. These are real truths which I have not revealed before because of my mentor, her commandment, and this is a very sacred place. I have very great memories at this place. I don't want to talk about me. So thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. But I will beg of you, ours is Rishi Marga. Only by adhering to Mahatmas, search for the Mahatma. Right now you have got Nochur Ramana. Not because I say so, he is a Mahatma. My dear brother, young brother, Sridhar, and all others, they are all benefiting. I would like you also make Sarada call nature here and then give talks. It is not the talk that matters, his presence matters. He is a Mahatma. Bhagavan will bless you. Bhagavan wanted this talk to be recorded and transcribed, and you take it. Thank you, Sarada Ambar.